Tonight is very little acidic, corrosive to the devil because of the multi-dimensional word that is coming tonight, as well as ministration. Somebody sent me a text yesterday and said, you brought us a guest minister in your mold. You know mold? So it looks like the man has a scientific background as well. I have failed and forgotten to announce, and the first thing I knew about him is that he's a trained pharmacist. Right? Pastor is medical doctor, and here is pharmacist. Is that not correct? So, we did pharmacology together, and pharmaceutics, and pharmacodynamics, and pharmacokinetics, and drug side effects, and adverse effects, and etiopathogenesis. And give the Lord a big clap of hand here today. So, in many ways, there will be a similarity of language. And normally you bring a guest minister like 15 to 30 minutes before he starts preaching. But he has been sitting here for almost 2 hours or more. And the reason why that is because he's not just here as guest minister. And there is something I will share with you that the Lord showed me. He's not just here as guest minister. He's here as us. Right? Hallelujah. And we appreciate him. He came all the way with Sister Rosemond. We appreciate you, ma'am. You haven't said anything to us. Can you come and at least greet the people? One word.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I don't know what to say, but as I stood there, I told God that there is something that is in this place that I'm taking back with me. When you lifted up the hankies and you began to worship and to praise the Lord, I lifted up my voice and I said, God, you have great people in this nation. And everywhere that the hankies were lifted up, I believe that anything that the enemy has decided to bring against you, that thing is coming down. As your praise goes up, that burden is coming down. As your praise goes up, that frustration is coming down. As your praise goes up, that challenge that you have in your life is coming down. The Lord richly bless you, Pastor. We have enjoyed such great hospitality whilst we are here. Mama, God bless you so much. I enjoy the word. May the Lord richly bless you. And never stop holding on to God. Never stop confessing that Jesus Christ is Lord. And never stop holding up the hands of the man of God. I believe that together we will take this nation for Christ. God richly bless you.
Praise and let us receive God's servant, Reverend Eastwood. Lift your hands in the worship of God. I told them that I will take them to my village. Go ahead and give the Lord the praise.
Beyond description too marvelous for words, too wonderful for comprehension, like nothing ever seen nor heard. Who can grasp your infinite wisdom? And who can fathom the depth of your love?
To him tonight. Oh, glory. So when the music fades, all is stripped away, and I simply come. Oh, longing just to bring something that's of worth, that will bless your heart. I'll bring you water and a song, for a song it is of, is not what you have required. Search much deeper within, through the waitings of it. You're looking into my heart. I'm coming back to heart of worship. It's all about you. It's all world. No one could express how much you deserve. Though I'm weak and poor, all I have is love. Every single
Amen. To be honest with you, I don't feel like preaching. I just sat there and I was soaking in the atmosphere and the various ministrations from the time of that sketch or drama that was staged. I said, what a ministration. Everything here so far has been edifying. And seriously, I have no business preaching or speaking, except that I believe that within a short time, somebody's life will be blessed. I sat down there and I watched Mama ministering. And I told the man of God and I told my wife, I said, this is incredible. I believe that Abuja and Nigeria will have to stop being greedy and export this couple to the world more. You know, I know we see him on television, but we also need him personally. Paul told the Romans, he said, Romans, I know you've heard about many things, but I long to see you, that I may impart unto you some spiritual gift. In other words, there are some gifts that cannot be sent online, and you cannot send them by television because they have to be body to body. Physical being to physical being. And even in Bogatanga, we need to see them there. We need to see them in Bogatanga, and maybe in case there is somebody listening to me in Bogatanga. And I can tell you, my people are watching. My executive assistant pastor told me today, he said, Daddy, what a word you preach there, and the ministry there is awesome. He's watching it, not even from Bogatanga, but from another town far away from Bogatanga. It's about maybe some 50 miles away from Bogatanga, in a very little village, a small town, and he's there, he's watching us live. And when I say that they should come to the place, I'm sure somebody's screaming an amen over there, though you are quiet, because you want to keep them to yourself. But from the days of John the Baptist until now, the kingdom of heaven suffered violence, and the violent take it by force. And we take this man of God and this woman of God by force, and we bring them into Ghana. But we will bring them for only 1 week and send them back to you. That should be done. That should be fine. That should be fine. Almighty Father, we thank you. Almighty Father, we thank you. We have nothing to give you, a little say thank you, Lord. Almighty Father, thank you. Thank you, Baba.
Almighty Father, thank you. Yeah. Almighty Father, thank you. We have nothing to give you, a little say thank you, Lord.
Be seated. Well, we thank God for what's such an incredible night. And I was sitting there and I'm like, so what is wrong with if sometimes I just fly from Ghana, come to Abuja, just attend these meetings, and I'm not preaching. I just come and sit down, enjoy the meeting, and fly back to Ghana. To be honest with you, I thought it would be worth it, because everything is so impactful and so edifying. And sometimes we will come here just to come and fellowship and be with you and say hello to you and sit in another plane and go back to Ghana. And it is worth it, because you know what? Sometimes in the ministry, you just need a friend who is not there because of preaching. You just need a brother. You just need a friend and a brother. Tonight, I I'm going to speak to you about open heaven. Jesus Christ and an open heaven. But it will not be the way you understand open heaven. It will be in a different direction. The Bible said in Luke chapter 3 and the verse number 21, and because of the way we've received so much already, I will take the preaching along as, sit down. Thank you. A time will come when you will get up. Jesus told these people, he said, a time is coming when you will, but for now. Luke chapter 3:21. Now when all the people were baptized, it came to pass that Jesus Christ also being baptized and praying, the heaven was open. Verse number 22. And the Holy Ghost descended in the bodily shape like a dove upon him, and a voice came from heaven which said, thou art my beloved son, in thee I am well pleased. A voice from heaven. A word came. We just heard from Mama that a word came and freed Joseph. Made him vice president. He began to command senators. But a voice from heaven. God spoke from heaven. And when the voice spoke, it didn't give Jesus a special revelation of the word of God. The voice only said, thou art my beloved son. In thee, I am well pleased. Today, may you hear that voice. Yeah. One day, about 2 months ago, the Lord showed me a vision. And in the vision, I saw a man sitting on a throne. That man's face was so glorious, so captivating, so powerful. Some people were running away from him. And I saw pastors and congregation alike. My wife and I were standing there. I saw some of the giant ministers in our country, Ghana, and around the world. And we were all standing there. And this man was sitting on the throne. And it was a time of judgment. My church members and I, we were all standing in the same place. Congregation, everybody was mixed up in the same market. Whenever you go to markets, something should tell you that on the day of judgment, there will be no VIP stand. If you want, you go to the market to go and buy Ashoki. You will realize that the place is the same. And then the man was calling people's names. When he called you, there was no argument or debate. He only said, he called people and they were waiting for just two words. Well done! And when he said, well done, a certain supernatural force picked up the people, threw them into some light, and they disappeared into light. But when he looked at other people and he didn't say well done, he only looked at them and went like this, with a stern eye, and darkness covered them, and they were whisked away. I was standing there and I was watching people going. And he said, I'm leaving you and Rosemond here so that you will see what is going on. He said, on that day, people will be waiting for only two words. Well done. Well done. Listen, it doesn't matter the number of things you hear from God. It doesn't matter how many revelations you receive. How many sermons you preach. By the grace of God, I've written 70 books. 70. All the 70 books, I type every letter myself. I put a computer on my lap and I type every letter from page 1 to the end. The books are not transcribed. I have received many revelations in life. But I have come to one conclusion that the greatest revelation I can ever hear, the greatest word of God I can ever hear is well done. The greatest word I can ever hear is, you are my son and I am well pleased in you. It came to pass that all the people being baptized, after they were baptized, it came to pass that Jesus also, everybody say Jesus also. Come on, shout it, Jesus also. Come on, shout it, Jesus also. Ayakabaha. Jesus also. Not in a special ceremony. Jesus also. Not by another preacher, but the same John the Baptist. Jesus also being baptized. Jesus also being baptized. Sinners were being baptized. Publicans were being baptized. Soldiers were being baptized. And they were being commanded to repent. Brood of vipers were being baptized. And yet here is Jesus, a man who knew no sin, had no Adamic nature, and he also being baptized. The day God will select you, you will also be among a group of people who look ordinary, simple. I sit in this church, and one of the greatest mysteries is when I see the nature of the people. I see the high and the low. This is one church. No matter who you are, you can come here and be comfortable. I saw people in slippers, sandals, simple people, ordinary people coming in. I see others in suit. I see others in nice bubu. I see some in t-shirt, polo, and we are all here. Jesus also. Sometimes you go to a meeting and you will not get a place over here to sit. You will sit in the overflow somewhere across the street. When it's raining, the rain will be falling on you. But tonight I bring you an announcement that you also, wherever you are sitting, in the overflow, in the crowd, the Bible said, and it came to pass that Jesus also, if it was another man of God or a big man of God who goes to a place and everybody is being baptized, you may ask for a special ceremony. I cannot be baptized with everybody, you know. I cannot be in this common crowd. You will need a separate place for me. But here is Jesus also going through baptism. And it was John the Baptist who was going to baptize him. And he's greater than John the Baptist. Because Jesus is greater than John the Baptist. John himself said, before I was, he was. He said, he's before me. He said, I am not worthy to unloose the shoe latchet of this man. He said, this man, he's spiritual and he's from heaven. I am natural. I'm from the earth. He said, this man is the bridegroom. I am the friend of the bridegroom. He said, this man is God walking in the flesh. He said, this is the Lamb of God that taketh away the sins of the world. And yet, Jesus stands in the queue. He stands in the line and he's waiting for his turn. He's waiting for his time to come. John the Baptist looked at Jesus in Matthew 3, 15, 16. He said, okay, you cannot be coming to me to baptize you. I must rather be baptized of you. And here is Jesus, humility, the Lamb of God that taketh away the sin of the world. He said, suffer it to be so for now, for thus it becometh to fulfill all righteousness. Ladies and gentlemen, there is something that will take you far in life. Humility. The willingness to be in the queue. The willingness to be an also. Everybody shout also. 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 There are times you also will go through pain and God will not give you special treatment. There are times you also will go through shame and God will not insulate you from it. There are times you also will have to join the queue. There are times you also will be having some difficulties. There are times you also will be looking for 20 naira and you cannot find it. And you will have to believe God for it. There are times you also, and it came to pass that Jesus also, being baptized and praying, the heaven was open. And when the heaven was open, a voice came from heaven. The word of God came from heaven. May you hear these sweetest words. Thou art my beloved son. In thee I am well pleased. May you hear a voice from heaven. Oh, you have no food to eat, but may you hear him say, you are my beloved son. Maybe at this point, not job. You will get a job. But even at this point that you have no job, you are my beloved son. Oh, at this point where you have no breakthrough ministry, the most important word for you to hear is, you are my beloved son, in whom I am well pleased. Jesus had been waiting for 30 years. Prakaroshikia. Can you imagine, you have come into the world? Everybody tells you are the Messiah. Everybody tells you are the Son of God. Everybody tells you have come to save the world. And for 30 years, there is no manifestation of your ministry. 30 years, no pulpit. The only pulpit he had was reading scriptures. 30 years, still the son of a carpenter. Oh, if it were you, you would be offended. Now you have come and John the Baptist, your cousin, who is less than you, smaller than you, cannot even lace your shoe latchet, is standing there baptizing, and everybody is coming to him, and Jesus comes and he's in the queue. Many preachers will be bitter, angry. How can this man baptize me? Jesus said, I'm in line. When it's my time, it will be my time. And it came to pass that Jesus also, being baptized and praying, I see somebody here, potential managing director, but you are a driver. Potential managing director, but you are a security man. Potential apostle in the faith, but right now you are playing an organ. I watched the man of God with the saxophone in his hand, or whichever one this one is, sax, and I can guess that at a point he played the saxophone. You see, because nobody becomes a very powerful preacher before he learns to play a saxophone. Most of the time in the upbringing and in the upcoming of their ministry, they play that instrument. And I'm sure there was a time he used to play and he was watching other men of God doing their own thing on the platform, and he's standing there with that saxophone. My lifetime, I will give God my lifetime. My lifetime, I will give God my lifetime. He give God my lifetime. He will take care of me. He will never let me down. I will give God my life. You are a king, but you are somebody's cook. You are a great man, but I see you in the queue. Anonymous, unassuming, you are waiting for your time. And because of his humility, being baptized, the heaven was open. And God said, indeed, I am well pleased. Now, when you hear that at a baptism, God is telling one person, in you I am well pleased, it means there were others he was not well pleased with. There was somebody God was not happy with. Number one, he was not happy and pleased with all the other people who were baptized. Why I'm saying that there are others he's not well pleased with is because this ceremony of baptism was it had similitude and resemblance with the baptism of the children of God under the Red Sea, in the Red Sea and under the cloud, when they were baptized unto Moses. And Paul wrote about the baptism of the Jews in 1 Corinthians chapter 10. You see, because when you read it in Exodus, you don't understand it was a baptism. Until Paul, by revelation, said when they were going through the Red Sea, it was not just going on a journey, but they were actually going through a baptism. And in 1 Corinthians 10, the verse number 1, my apostle, your apostle, my mentor, your mentor, Timothy's spiritual father, your spiritual great, 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 great grandfather, Paul the apostle, one of the few people on earth who could say, I have fought the good fight of faith, I have finished my course, henceforth is laid for me a crown. I'm talking about the apostle, who was not only a preacher, but he was a teacher. And not just a teacher, he was a writer of things that would later on be canonized as scripture. I'm talking about Paul the apostle, that man who God did not delegate his conversion, but gave himself, and Jesus himself personally encountered him on the road to Damascus, because Paul must be inferior to no other apostle. I hear him boast about his apostle credential, and he said, have I not seen Jesus? John saw Jesus, I saw him. Peter saw Jesus, I saw him. James saw Jesus, I saw him. I come behind no apostle in any gift and grace of God. I have seen Jesus. I'm talking about Paul.
I'm talking about that apostle, that great man of God. He said, moreover, to the Corinthians, I would not have you to be ignorant how that all our fathers were under the cloud and they all passed through the sea, and the Bible said then they were all baptized unto Moses and in the cloud, and they all did eat the same spiritual meat, and they all did drink the same spiritual drink, for they drank of the rock that followed them, and that rock was Christ. But the Bible said, but with many of them God was not well pleased, but they were overthrown in the wilderness. So they were baptized, God was not pleased with them. They went through the cloud, God was not pleased with them. They went through the water, God was not pleased with them. But Jesus being baptized, God said, thou art my beloved son, indeed I am well pleased. I see somebody here. There are many associate pastors, God is not well pleased with them. There are many people God has called, but God is not well pleased with them. But I see you called, I see you chosen, I see you sanctified. Many are called, but few are chosen. Come on, shout like I'm talking to you. But with many, God was not well pleased. And when I was preaching, when I was preparing a word one day, and I was writing this book, Jesus Christ and an Open Heaven, when I got to indeed, I am well pleased. You know, there are scriptures you read and you interpret by an inward witness. But this one, I was reading the scripture and God spoke to me. God spoke to me, because you cannot find this one in a commentary. God himself told me. He said, my son, when I said indeed, I am well pleased, I was not just comparing Jesus with the general congregation. I was comparing him with Lucifer and Adam. Lucifer and Adam. He said, this is not the only one I sent into the world. At the point, my chief messenger, my chief representative was Lucifer in the beginning of creation. Lucifer disappointed me. At a certain point, I invested all my trust in Adam. Adam, let me down. Concerning Lucifer, my Bible said in two places, Ezekiel chapter 28 and the verse number 11. Moreover, he said, the word of the Lord came unto me saying, take up a lamentation against, or take up a lamentation upon the king of Tyros, and say unto him, thou sayest the Lord, thou sealest up the sun, full of wisdom, perfect in beauty. Amplified version says, you are the full measure. He said, you are the full measure. You seal up the psalm. You are the full measure. And you are the pattern of exactness. He said, you are the symbol of anything. You put finishing touch on anything that constitutes completeness. Lucifer, that is who you are. Full of wisdom. Perfect in beauty. He said, Lucifer, you were perfect in beauty. Every precious stone was your covering. Precious stones, 9 of them. 12 on the breastplate of the high priest. You carrying 9 of them, embedded in a setting of gold. He said, every precious stone was your covering. Lucifer, you had the sardius and the topaz and the diamond and the beryl and the onyx and the jasper and the sapphire and the emerald and the carbuncle, all of them in settings of gold. He said, the workmanship of your tablet and your pipes were prepared in you in the day you were found. He said, you were perfect in all your ways until iniquity was found in you. And when iniquity was found in you, I had no choice but to cast you out as profane from the holy mountain of God. I would destroy you. He said, I will cast you down, and I will lay you before kings, and they will behold you. Isaiah resonated the same thing, reverberated the same thing that Ezekiel was saying. Isaiah put it this way in Isaiah chapter 14. Isaiah 14. He said, How art thou fallen, O Lucifer, son of the morning? How thou art thou cast to the ground, thou that weaken this deep weaken the nation, because thou hast said in your heart, I will ascend into heaven. I will exalt my throne above the stars of God. I will sit also in the mount of the congregation, in the sides of the north. I will ascend above the heights of the clouds. I will be like the Most High God. And God said, because you lifted up your heart, I will bring you down to hell. And I will put you in a pit. So you see, here is Lucifer, lifted up himself. God brought him down. Here is Adam. God said, let's make man in our own image, after our likeness. Let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, fowl of the air, over the cattle, over the earth, over every creeping thing that creepeth upon the face of the earth. And God now blessed man and said, be fruitful, multiply, replenish the earth, subdue it, have dominion over everything that moves upon the face of the earth. Created man in his own image. God loaded man. God gave man gifts. God anointed man. He gave Adam great capacity. My Bible said in the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 45, 1 Corinthians 15, I beg your pardon, 15 verse number 45, he said Adam was a living soul, but Jesus was the quickening spirit. But Adam was made first, the first Adam, and Jesus is the last Adam. So you see, over here at the baptism of Jesus, God is making comparison. He's comparing Adam with Jesus. He's comparing Lucifer with Jesus. And you that I'm talking to today, anything God has called you to do, he has called somebody there before. Whatever you are doing for God, somebody was called and they disappointed God. Man of God, many people have broken God's heart. One day I was going to preach this message. I was in the bedroom, deep in the night, 1 a.m., 2 a.m. I was walking in my bedroom and praying. The prayer was said that my wife couldn't even hear me praying because the prayer was so vocal. I was just walking in the room. Yakaba, shikibi yakaba, shikibi yakaba, shikibi yakaba, shikibi yakaba. The Lord told me, he said, my son, many people have broken my heart. He said, like Lucifer and Adam, I was not well pleased with them. They broke my heart. He said, I gave them an anointing. They corrupted the anointing. Look at Lucifer. Thou art the anointed cherub that covereth. And I have set you so. I made you to walk on the coals of fire. I anointed you, Lucifer. I put you on the mountain. But Lucifer, Lucifer, look at you. Look at you, Lucifer. Lucifer, you've disappointed me. Lucifer, look at you. Look at you. Look at you. And God told me, said, anything I called you to do, there was a time I called other people to do it. They disappointed me. He asked me, Eastwood, are you going to disappoint me? He said, I have called many men of God. They disappointed me. I called many men of God. I gave them things. They disappointed me. Here is Jesus also being baptized. Jesus also being baptized. Jesus also being baptized. Jesus also being baptized. God the Father looked from heaven, looked at Jesus and said, as for this one, I can trust him. This one will not fail until he says it is finished. This one will not fail until he says, not my will, but thy will be done. This one will not fail until, even when he's shouting, my God, why hast thou forsaken me? He will remember that God is his Father and will say, Father, into thy hands I commend my spirit. I see somebody sitting here right now. You have a little position. You have a little place you occupy. A little money in your hand. A little anointing in your hand. You come from a little town, from a little city, from a little part of the world that is called Abuja. Man of God, your ministry is not in Texas. Your ministry is not in New York. Your ministry is not in Sydney or Australia. Your ministry is not in London. Your ministry is in Nigeria. They call this part of the world the third world. But look at what you have done with an ordinary third world country. Look at what you have done with people giving offerings. Sometimes just 10 naira. Some of them giving 500 naira. Little monies in envelopes over here. Look at what you have done. Look at the ministry you have built. A ministry that is touching many nations. Some people got more money than that. They got more anointing than that. They got more grace than that. They got more connection. They were supported from foreign nations and they still disappointed God. God anointed them, they messed up the anointing. But man of God, look at the little you have done with what God has put in your hands. Look at what you've done with simple people. Look at what you have done with ordinary people. And I came here to tell somebody that just as this man of God and this woman of God can work with something little God has put in their hands, I see you also. You don't need a huge capital. You don't need a big connection. You can do something with little. I see a David with a little stone, but you will bring down a Goliath. I see a widow woman here talking to a prophet Elisha. Man of God, my servant is dead, and the creditors have come to take our children and make them slaves. And the man of God said, what do you have in your house? She said, I have just a little oil. He said, God can use a little oil. God can use oil that is in the cruise. And now I'm talking to somebody here tonight. You don't have plenty of money, but that little money you have, even if it's just 1,000 naira, I speak the power of God upon it. Just like Elijah stood in front of the widow woman in Sarepta and said, woman, hear my voice. Thus saith the Lord, the bowl, the cruise, the barrel of meal shall not be wasted, and the cruse of oil shall not fail until God brings rain to the earth. I am talking to somebody right now. Your little money will accomplish a purpose. Look at you with a simple wife, but you are working signs and wonders. Your wife is not a Princess Diana. Your wife is a little Fulani woman, a little Yoruba woman, a little Igbo woman from somewhere in the corner in the world. But out of that little woman, I see you raise somebody more than a queen, somebody more than the Queen of Sheba. I see a woman in the building here. Your husband is a little man. Your husband is an organizer. He's just a mechanic. He's not an engineer. Your husband is not the founder of a church, and he's not the general overseer of a church. Your husband is a pastor, and he's just the driver of the senior pastor. But I see God, who chooses the foolish things of the world to confound the things that are wise, the things that are mighty and that are not mighty, the weak things of the world, the base things of the world, the things that are despised and the things that are not, has God chosen that he may bring to naught the things that are. I see somebody right now, you look very small, you are at the back of the line. Don't commit suicide, because suicide is suicidal. Don't commit suicide. Suicide is suicidal. You will not die, but you will live to declare the words of God. I speak to your little oil. I speak to your little self. Greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. Here is Jesus also being baptized. People were baptized before Jesus. He said, I don't have to be the first to receive an approval, for the first shall be the last, and the last shall be the first. It is not of him that willeth, nor of him that runneth, but of God that showeth mercy. It's not by might, it's not by power, but by my spirit, saith the Lord. Abuja, Nigeria, hear the sound of my voice. They that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. Abuja, Nigeria, Africa, hear my sound. The people that sit in darkness shall be a light. They shall see a light. I see you here right now. You will shine like the brightness of the feminine. You will shine like the light forever. I see Christ in you, the hope of glory. Arise, shine. Your light is come. The glory of the Lord is risen upon you. Darkness shall cover the earth, and gross darkness shall cover the people. But the Lord shall arise upon you. I see you become different. Jesus is in the queue. He also being baptized. He is not the first. He is not the second. He is not the third. He is not the fourth. He is not the fifth. Maybe he is about the number 200 to be baptized on that day. But he said, though I stay at the back, a light can shine on me. Though I am in the overflow, a light can shine on me. I came here to talk to somebody today, you don't have to be the first, you don't have to be the biggest, you don't have to be the smartest, you don't have to be the most intelligent, you don't have to be the richest, you don't have to be the strongest, but I see God open the windows of heaven and he's speaking a word. You are my beloved son, in you I am well pleased. Come on, scream like your voice is yours and praise.
Many have disappointed him. He gave them money, millions of dollars. They couldn't do anything with it. I've been here a few days. I didn't see special offering. I just saw baskets. People dropping in little money. The man of God and his wife rather drop in almost everything they have. Man of God, can you please come? Because the Lord showed me something to do. Somebody give me anointing oil. Kindly stretch forth your hand. The Lord said I should tell you that because you have done this with little, he will give you much. He said the match is coming until you don't know what to do with it. Kaboshi. Shadaba Osika. Yenemeke Feri Kadushi. Andasaniya Mekaba. Look at you. Little oil. Little oil. But you will do much with the little oil. I see you save the world with little oil. There are people in this building who are waiting for much. Lord, if you can give me millions. God said, you don't need millions. Joseph saved the world with an idea, not millions. Receive it tonight. May God open the windows of heaven. I was sitting here today. The Lord said to me, there are many people who are at the point of suicide. They think life is hopeless. They've waited for breakthrough upon breakthrough, and the breakthrough is not coming. They feel they should die. God says the amount of life that is left in you is like a flicker of light. Out of that flicker of light, he will create an inferno of a fire. You don't have to die. Lift up your hand and shout, I shall not die, but I will live to declare the works of God. Here is Jesus also being baptized. The heaven was open. People were being baptized. Everybody was being baptized. Listen, ladies and gentlemen. Sometimes it is the same communion service everybody is taking. Oh, glory. Or if I go to the meeting, if the man of God can lay hands on me, I'll be anointed. Sometimes the blessing will not come by the man of God singling you out to lay hands on you. The man of God may just say, everybody scream. And while everybody is screaming, and you also screaming, but believing God, something will happen to your life. The Lord told me, he said, my son, many people have broken my heart. I said, Lord, I need further explanation. God said, I gave many people wives. I gave many people my precious daughters. They messed them up. They messed them up. Until my daughters are walking about in town and they look like mad women. Because my own sons messed them up. Today, God has given you a wife. But what will be the story of that wife 10 years from now? God gave Dr. Mrs. Eninche a husband. See what she has helped the man to become. What will you do with your own? You will mess him up until his ministry is broken down and the man is in shame and in pieces. Oh God, anything you give to your children and you give me also, help me to take care of it well. God gave you beautiful sisters, Christian sisters. Instead of helping them to be holy, you are fornicating with all of them, committing adultery with all of them. God brought an innocent woman who just did HND in secretarial course for you to help this 20-year-old girl to find her future. Innocent girl. She walked through your office. And the first day she walked through your office, she called you daddy. Daddy, I need employment as a secretary. 1 year down the line, she has already committed 3 abortions because of you. You took that child of God. You messed her up. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm talking to anybody today who is in a queue with something small, a little opportunity God has given to you. Many people have messed up already. Since I came here, I asked Pastor a question every way. Man of God, what do I do? How should this happen? How should that happen? And that is because I know I'm not the first person to preach for him. I know before I came here, there were many. So me also being baptized and preaching, I want an opening heaven. Am I talking to somebody at all? Over my life. Because if I can be faithful with this pulpit, God will give me another pulpit. Listen to me, ladies and gentlemen. You have an opportunity. Look at you. I came to tell you tonight, for somebody, as I close, don't look at where you are in the line. You have been faithful with a little. There are people here today with very little education, and still with that little education, you are trying to receive the word of God. There are people with a lot of education who have thrown God away. Look at you. Sick. Still coming to church. Sick. But the little life in you, you sit in an overflow. And sometimes the rain falls on you. Tonight, in the name of Jesus, if Jesus also being baptized, the heaven was open. You also coming to this all night vigil, may heaven open over your life. May heaven open over your life in the name of Jesus. Come on, shout the heaven open, scream it, and the heaven will open in the name of Jesus. At the time Jesus was being baptized, soldiers were baptized, publicans were baptized, great people were being baptized, and Jesus also, son of the carpenter, being baptized. Look at you. I'm talking to somebody who feels like dying on the inside. You don't have to die. That little life will do wonders. One day I was driving in Bogatanga, where I come from. I call Bogatanga a city by faith, but in terms of classification of cities, it will be a town. That is if it is fortunate. I was driving in the city of Bogatanga early morning, And I saw a young lady. And I stopped the car and I said, I've seen you before in our church. She said, yes, Pastor. I've come there before. I said, where are you going? She said, I'm going to school. I'm a teacher. I said, can you see me and Mama at home when you close school today? She said, yes, sir, I'll be there. She closed school, came to the house, and when we were talking to her, we realized that she told us, she said, that day, she had decided to commit suicide. And she was just going to teach, and after the teaching, she would end her life. But when I spoke to her, she realized she doesn't have to kill herself. So we made her rededicate her life to Christ, and we talked to her. As I speak to you now, she is studying for her master's degree now. She's also married to a pastor, and they have how many children? 3 children. She didn't die. Life is not my own. To you I belong. I give my life. I give myself to you. Life is not my own. To you I belong. Say, I give myself. I give myself to you. I give myself away so you can use me. I give myself away. Oh, I give myself away so you can use me. Here I stand. Say, for here I stand, Lord, my life is in your hand. Lord, I'm longing to see your desire revealed in me. Oh, I give myself away. I surrender all to you. Everything I give to you, withholding nothing, withholding nothing, withholding nothing. Withholding nothing, withholding nothing. Look at me, look at me. These cameramen are so good that if I say look at me, no matter where you are looking, your eyeballs will hit mine. And fortunately for me, naturally, my eyeballs are so big that if you look at me, you will get maximum connectivity. So look at me, eyeball to eyeball. You don't have to die. Man of God, I am convinced within all my heart that there are people here tonight under the sound of my voice. They have given up to the point that in the next 1 month, they will not be alive. But for the divine intervention of tonight, lift up your hands. If you are standing anywhere and you are contemplating suicide, I want to kill myself. You are contemplating, you have even tried it and it didn't work, and you are saying, Lord, I can't live even for the next 1 week, 1 month. Come to this preacher down here right now. Thank you, Jesus. From the overflow, from the top, from the bottom, everywhere, you are contemplating suicide. Withholding nothing. Withholding nothing. I surrender all to you. Everything I give to you. Withholding nothing. Withholding nothing. Withholding nothing. Withholding nothing. Hallelujah. Those of you who are coming to me, I want you to stand. I want you to stand. I want you to take a posture of beginning to rise up in life. So stand. Don't kneel. Stand. Don't kneel. Stand. Don't kneel down. Stand. Gentlemen, come to me here, young man. Come here. Come on, sir. Somebody give me some anointing oil. Ayakaba. Usher, watch me. Usher. Just stand. Hey.
So this is my desire to honor you, Lord, with my heart, I worship you. All I have within me, I give you praise. All I have, adore is in you. Lord, I give you my heart, I give you my soul, yeah, yeah, yeah. I live for you alone, every breath that I take, every moment I'm away.
We had a service for students in our church in Bogatanga. It was time for questions, and I was ministering with one of my best friends in Ghana, Dr. Mensah Otabo. He came to visit me in Bogatanga to speak in our church. And it was question time, and one of the young people got up and he said, "Sir, I have a question." And Dr. Mensah Otabo said, "What is your question?" He said, "When I grow up, I want God to give me plenty of money so that I will build an auditorium like the one Brother Eastwood has built." I said in my head, "Fools are never in short supply. You have to be a fool to think like that." to think money is the thing that is doing this ministry. It's not money. It is a certain heart. God has looked at the heart of a man, which is drawing all kinds of people. Listen, this room is even already overcrowded. Not to talk about an overflow. It's the grace of God that keeps us here. For a man who is faithful like that, God will give him the Lord's garden. So, the heart of the man is what is producing all these. And the heart of the man, it will amaze you, the millions of people in the world that watch this satellite TV, and their lives are being saved and healed on a daily basis. What you carry in your heart determines what God will put in your hand. I've seen tears here. Ushers, block the line for me. Don't let anybody come again. Because there are people, if they realize I start laying hands on people, they'll also start coming. Even if I say I want people with 20 legs to come forward, some people will come. So block the aisle. Don't let anybody come. But there is something called the oil of gladness. I pray that the oil of preservation. Come here, my sister. Give me some oil in my hand. Kabasha. My wife was being prophetic. She said, should I put some oil in a bowl for you? And I said, no. Now I'm paying for disobeying my wife. Receive it. Ha! Tabata. Lift up your hands, those of you in front of me. Receive life. Receive the will to live. Anybody you ever hear committed suicide, most of the time, they died months and years before they committed the physical suicide, because they give up within them and they wish they were dead. You don't have to die. Ushers, try something for me. Try getting them to me two at a time. One towards my left, one to my right. So I surrender all.
Oh. stand. No matter what may come my way, my life is in your hand. With Jesus I can take it. With Him I know I can stand. No matter what may come my way, my life is in your hand.
With Jesus I can take it.
With Jesus I can take it. With Him I know I can stand. No matter what may come my way, my life is in your hand.
With Jesus,
with Jesus I can take it. With Him I know I can stand. No matter what may come my way, my life is in your hand.
Sing it one more time.
With Jesus I can take it. With Him I know I can stand. No matter what may come my way, my life is in your hand.
Let me close like this. Let me close like this. Kaboshi. Several years ago, I knew a man. He was not an apostle or a prophet. We used to call him by a simple name in Ghana, Brother Kizzy Hayford. This man, one day, he wanted water to wash his clothing, and rain had not been falling for some time, and the taps were locked, as is the custom of Africa. So the man had no water. And he prayed a prayer. He said, Lord, I want it to rain only in my house so that I can collect the rainwater from my roof and use it to wash my clothing. And he stood in front of his house and prayed that prayer. Within minutes, it started raining only on his house. He collected the water and washed his clothing. I tell you the truth. Paul wrote to the Corinthians, he said, I tell you the truth and I lie not, that God is my witness, whom I serve with my spirit. But I tell you the truth, that today, before I came to this meeting, in the afternoon, I did a lot of praying. And I saw heaven open. But this heaven open, man of God, it was like this light in size. It was not a big heaven open. It was like the light this size. And the rain was falling on individuals. Everybody with his own open heaven. Today, anybody in this building who is like me, when I said like me, God said I should wipe my sweat and put it on your head. Anybody like me, and you know like me, there are times in my life, because of where I come from and where I live, I can feel very small like that. One day I saw a revelation. My face and the faces of other men of God. I knew the faces. The faces were big. And the neck holding up the heads were very big necks. I was in Amsterdam. When I looked under my head, doctor, the neck holding my head was tiny like this. I said, God, why? Why? The Lord told me, he said, son, all the faces you saw, you can tell what is holding them up there. They have the advantage of geographical location. They have people around them. They have the skills and the physical resources to keep them up there. But you, He said, that tiny thing you saw there is my grace. My grace is the thing that is keeping your head up there. Somebody here, hear the sound of my voice. I have resisted standing on this chair for about 30 minutes now. This is where to stand. Receive it. This is where to stand, because in this zone, somebody lift up your hand. The heaven over your head is open. You are hearing a simple word. In thee, I am well pleased. I heard the man of God talking about you yesterday. I hear the Spirit of the Lord say, apostolic grace. Apostolic grace. Apostolic grace. This house, listen, this house is a house of apostolic grace. Some of you have a little gift, and if God is pleased with you, if a man's ways please God, even your enemies will be at peace with you. And the little gift you have, wherever it turns, it will prosper. Amen. Lift up your hand. Keep quiet. Organ, shut. Kaboshi. I promise you, 3 minutes, I'm away from this pulpit. Because what I hear the Holy Ghost talking about is 3 minutes. He said, don't stay up there longer. Don't stay up there longer. Receive it. What you need is an open heaven. You don't need a man to help you. No, you are thinking about somebody to help you. A doctor, a lawyer, a banker. No. Receive open heaven. Come on. Come on. It's raining. It's raining. It's raining. It's raining. Some of you can feel physical rain. You can feel water on your body. It's raining. It's raining. It's raining. It's raining. It's raining. It's raining. I hear the Spirit of God telling me, not less than 5,000 people in this environment and this atmosphere are receiving a tangible rain of God on their body. They can feel their bodies are becoming weak, are becoming wet. I beg your pardon. Some of them can feel water collecting under their feet. Right now, it's raining. Come on, it's raining. Take it. It's raining. You have 1.5 minutes more. Lift up your hand and stand in that rain. Stand in the rain. Stand in the rain. Stand in the rain. Ha! Stand in the rain. I see you becoming fruitful. I see you multiply. Replenish the earth. Subdue it. Have dominion. That is your mandate. Come on, take it. Receive it. It's happening. 30 seconds more. Flow in it. Kabacha, kabata, tata. Somebody begin to pray, Lord, open the windows of heaven over my life. Open the windows of heaven over my life. Open the windows of heaven over my life, over my ministry, over my business, over my life, over my ministry, over my business. Come on, somebody take it right now. The heaven over you is opening right now. The heaven over you is opening right now. Every gift in your life is becoming sharper. The gift of God in your life is becoming sharper. Receive it. Come on, keep praying. Keep praying. Keep praying. Keep praying. Open heaven. Let it rain. Let it rain. Open heaven. Let the voice of God speak. May you hear it. It doesn't matter what your wife is saying about you. God says in you, I am well pleased.
It doesn't matter what the banker is saying about you. God says in you, I am well pleased. It doesn't matter what your husband, your wife are saying. God says, indeed, I am well pleased. Somebody lift up your hand and begin to thank God that he's thinking well of you. He's thinking well of you. God is thinking well of you. God is thinking well of you. What's happening to that woman? Father, in the name of Jesus, complete and total recovery. Yabaraka bahata. I rebuke you, foul spirit. I take authority over you right now. I bind you, foul spirit, and I command you in the name of Jesus, come out of her this minute. Now, go. Thank you, Jesus. I give you glory. Kaboshi, lift up your hand and speak to God. Your open heaven. Begin to thank God, my friend. Begin to thank God for your open heaven. Come here, my friend. Come here. Come here. Come here. Receive it. Open heaven. Somebody receive it. The heaven over you open. The heaven over you. Somebody whisper this after me. Lord Jesus, I am a stranger to discouragement. Right now, I confess it is my time also to have one opportunity. And I see heaven over my head is open. I hear the voice of God. In you, I am well pleased. Father, I receive your word into my spirit. In you, I am well pleased. Indeed, I am well pleased. I receive your word into my life that you are pleased with me. In the name of Jesus, somebody shout an amen. Scream an amen. Hallelujah. Henceforth. Henceforth. Wherever you go, listen to two things. Wherever you go, if there is a queue, join it. You may see somebody baptizing. His name is John. Jesus saw John the Baptist baptizing. He said, John, baptize me. Humble yourself. At this stage in your life, the main thing God needs from you is a little humility. And I can tell you, humility is lacking in the kingdom. May God help you. Humble yourself. My wife and I, we want to thank doctors and ninjas for bringing us here. We have enjoyed our stay. We thank you very much for receiving us. You know, we've never been here. And when we're coming, we're thinking all kinds of things. Man of God, you won't believe it. I came with a wallet full of money. I said, hey, give me money. I'm going to Abuja. I don't know what may befall me. And we have come. And Victor, what a wonderful man of God. They've taken good care of us so much. Dr. Nietzsche and the wife, yesterday they took us to their house and we really had a good meal. And I told them, I said, it's not everywhere you go that the senior pastor takes you to his house. And for me and my wife, we value things like that. They are more important to us than preaching. This preaching is hard labor with frustration. But going to his house to eat was enjoyment with maximum hospitality. And what a simple man of God and a simple woman of God. One thing I wish I could do like them was their dancing. I watch pastor and he goes something like this. And I try to do it with my long body and long legs. It's not working. As for mama's own, maybe my wife can try.
But, and the depth of the word. And you know what, people? There is a gift this family or this couple are giving to you, which I know has escaped your notice. In our generation, it is close to impossible to see a man and his wife synchronized like this. Now, if I would tell you, no. Many marriages out there are battlefields. When you see them together like this, it's the best gift they can give you. Can I? We want to beg you. Want to beg you. That this man of God and this woman of God, please keep them well. They are not angels. They are human beings. When you disagree with them, pray for them. Don't crucify them. When they stand, the little they can offer, take it in your hand and multiply it. And we pray in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. That God will bless your life.
Amen.
We love you in a special way.
Amen.
And we pray that the grace of God will keep you.
Amen.
God mightily bless you.
Amen.
Shall we welcome the woman of God?